to Channel 80 News. I'm your host, Joseph Chapman, and now you're breaking stories. In entertainment news, Justin Bieber's entourage has been arrested under suspicion of kidnapping and pedophilia, but they were later released when they realized that the pop star travels with a huge group of black men for no apparent reason. In transportation news, the administration has released that in the next 30 years, they will try to improve gas mileage by 2 miles per gallon, because anything more might stress out their oil barons. In related news, Bigfoot was recently arrested as well for driving with a DUI record and not having a license. He's being deported back to Canada, where he will take part in the next Olympics. Thank you.
Here we are, at the most useless beach in the world on the coldest, windiest day ever. So cold, you don't even want to know. It's so incredibly cold. Not even the craziest of crazy people are surfing. That's right. And by the way, 50 people were murdered.
And now for a Channel 80 News Meaning of Life.
Hi, I'm Hollywood LaMarmar, and after a 5-year summer hiatus, People is back. Allow me to introduce our first guest of the day, Conrad Ruction. What a jolly fellow.
Oh, well, I don't know about that.
We actually have an audience? Oh my god. Publishers did a good job this time. All right, so Conrad, what brings you on the show today?
I was in the area, you know, I was working on the Willamette Bridge, you know, the one that connects Oregon and Australia. We've been working on that for a few years now.
And how's that been going for you?
It's going pretty good. It's pretty hard to keep the horses off the tracks. You know, for some reason horses are really attracted to Australia. We haven't figured that out yet, but we're working on that.
So how have you solved the problem of all of that water in between here and Australia?
You know, it takes a lot of boats and a lot of concrete, I'll tell you that much. We get pretty hungry out there. We have a tendency to just eat seaweed.
And how do you cook that?
We don't.
Ooh, raw, how primal.
Yeah, it's delicious, trust me.
All right, well, do you have any estimate on when this project is going to be completed?
2050.
2050, ooh, a long time. Nice job security, though.
I don't know about that. I'm eating seaweed.
Oh, well, pity about that. All right, and for our next guest, we have somebody named Lady Dramamine. And we're back, and it appears that Lady Dramamine is still stuck in the green room, so we're going to continue with Conrad here. Now, we've heard some rumors about vagrants that are just waiting for the trains to get started. What's up with that?
We have a bunch of people going on a hunger strike. They've been getting in the way. They seem to... I'm not even really sure. They're going on a hunger strike waiting for the train to be done. We have openly stated at several of our press conferences that this won't be done until 2050. We're just going to wait a few months and wait for them to thin out and then just call the police, I guess.
Ooh, thin out with a hunger strike. That could be disastrous.
Anyway,
for your PR,
do you have any other questions for me?
Yes, actually, we've also heard some rumors about other sorts of vandals and terrorist attacks on the train. Can you shed any light on that situation?
We've had a lot of militants trying to attack the train. It's much just like the hunger strike thing. No, nothing that they're saying or doing is making any sense, but you know, what are you gonna do?
Well, we actually have a transcript of one of these events that was published on YouTube, and they're saying things like "R matey." Is that some sort of Aboriginal language, or?
No, we believe that they're pirates, actually. We believe that these are the undead descendants of Blackbeard himself. And they've risen from the dead, trying to recapture the sea that they once owned themselves.
Ah, so there's a little bit of a property dispute with the previous owners, then.
Ah, yes, we're having, let's say, major issues.
There's also been reports that some of the construction materials, and this doesn't make sense to me at all, folks, that some of the construction materials have been in open revolt.
Yeah, we apparently got a shipment from the Talking Rocks, I believe. I don't know all the details about it. But the rocks themselves have become angry or enraged since they've been dug up and turned into concrete, and they have a tendency to yell at us with extreme prejudice while we're working. And,
that's such a shame.
Yes. It is not fun at all when your working materials are screaming at you and hoping you die.
Ooh, so lots of challenges ahead for the construction of the Willamette Bridge. All right, and I believe my producer is giving me the signal that Lady Dramamine has finally made her way out of the green room. So allow me to welcome Lady Dramamine.
Hello. Excuse me.
Hi.
Thank you. Hi. Sorry about that. I got a ghost stuck in my hair while I was in the green room, so, you know.
Absolutely fascinating. And is the bottle part of that?
Well, yeah, I put the ghost in the bottle. Can you see him?
I think so. Not entirely sure. So yes, what exactly is it that you do?
Oh, I capture, you know, supernatural stuff. Ghosts, genies, werewolves.
And you put them all in the bottle?
Yeah.
After a long day of farming, are you tired of your donkeys having lackluster results?
Yes.
You need Mod Podge! Mod Podge will help make your donkey quite succulent for the winter feasts.
How much?
Twice as much.
Cool.
After a long day of digging a well, are you tired and thirsty?
Yes.
Does the water taste terrible?
Yes.
You need Mod Podge. It'll make it taste much better.
Whoa! Will it taste like strawberries?
Twice as much.
Cool!
After a long drive home from work, are you exhausted?
Yes.
Do you need more energy?
Yep.
You need Mod Podge.
Whoa!
Is your cat ill and peeing on everything in sight?
Yes.
You need Mod Podge to clog up those urinary glands.
Whoa!
After working on the garden, are you just tired of all brambles choking out your wonderful produce?
Yes.
You need to poison them with Mod Podge.
Whoa!
It'll make your life twice as wonderful.
Great! Where can I get them?
Online, at this number, shown on your screen now.
What number?
The number right below your head.
How do I get it?
In the mail, with fast delivery between 4 to 9 months.
Really?
It'll arrive right at your house. Whoa. Mod Podge! Mod Podge does not endorse the presidency of the United Arab Emirates.
Can anyone drink these?
Yes, they can, unless they're epileptic, diabetic, or hypoglycemic, or allergic to the color red.
Sweet!
Wait.
Okay, it appears our producer has been a little bit out of practice in the last 5 years, so sorry about that unintended commercial break there, folks. Anyway, how exactly does your system work? I mean, it doesn't seem possible to fit a werewolf into a little bottle like that. Is it supernatural or scientific means?
It's, you know, supernatural, like everything else. You just kind of... And then it's in there.
All right. So it just kind of sucks it in there?
Yeah, like a vacuum cleaner, but with less noise. It's really handy.
Okay, does it actually damage any of the creatures that you put inside of it?
Sometimes they get, you know, bruises, missing ears. It happens, but you can fix that.
And what do you do with the creatures once you've captured them? Do you study them, or,
it's really useful to, you know, train them to do housework and stuff.
Oh.
You know, I run a house cleaning business on the side. I do it with ghosts. People are like, wow, it's amazing because I never see the maid come in. And it's because they're ghosts, see? So nobody sees them.
That sounds interesting. And how much are your services running?
Pretty cheap compared to other places because, you know, you don't really have to pay a ghost anything for manual labor if you've captured it and made it into your slave, so.
Alright, and are there any consequences to your immortal soul for doing any of this?
That remains to be seen, but you know, I think I'll be okay.
So no curses, no calls for vengeance from the grave?
Occasional curses. I had this 1 week for my shoelaces.
I think that werewolf is a little upset with her right now.
I had this 1 week where my shoelaces kept tying themselves together, and, you know, I had to wear flats all week. I don't really like flats, but, you know.
Well, I've actually found that rubber shoes are very nice and not terribly fashionable, I must say, which is a little bit of a faux pas on my part, but they're so comfortable.
I'm going to have to try those out.
They're not that expensive anymore, so all right. And now we will cut to a real commercial break. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
Do you have a house? Is it messy sometimes? Well, I'm Lady Dramamine, and you should try my cleaning service. Call now.
Warning. May offend black people, may have ghosts, may have vampires, may have Twilight, a fiction of yours, and may have pale, ghostly people rape you. So, be warned.
And welcome back to People. We would like to introduce a fitness segment right now. And
fitness!
Thank you, Mr. Producer. And we will start this out with Mr. What was it again?
Abs Fabley,
sorry.
Are you ready?
I think I am.
You don't look dressed for it.
I know, I should get rid of the coat.
But you were in Hollywood, I understand.
Thank you.
I was Hollywood star in the 80s. You remember my movie, Coders and Kill?
I don't think so. Is it available on DVD for me to rent?
Straight to Laserdisc.
Straight to Laserdisc. Well, we might have some of that back in the equipment room that we can borrow, put together if we can find it. All right, so what is your first tip for us today?
Well, you must do the exercise every day. Well, not every. Every week, maybe a month.
Okay. And how do you condense your exercise into just a small window of time for once a month?
I take the fatty and I push him through the window and he is condensed.
Oh. And what exactly do you do after he's through the window?
He is very much, if he does not lose the weight, he will not fit through the window.
All right.
It is very tough love, but it is my program.
Are there any other elements to your program then, or is it just a defenestration?
Well, the defenestration,
the throwing of somebody out a window.
Oh, yes, that is basic exercise. But we also do the ab crunch.
Okay.
And the jog.
I think I can do that one myself. Let's see.
And then the jumping jog.
Oh, that's one I haven't seen before. Oh, do be careful, though. You don't want to fall into the lake.
Yes, we are at the studio of the lake. It's very scenic.
Well, we've been off the air for 5 years. We kind of had to go
canceled.
With what we...
Oh, lake canceled. I know like that.
I've
had animated series that was canceled. I said the B word in the pilot. They did not like it.
Ooh, yeah, that's a tough one. They censors.
I'm sorry. Is that okay to say now?
FCC.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, dear. We just came back. What are we going to do?
I will take care of it. I have many connection in Hollywood.
Oh, thank God.
Connection accepted.
Yes,
wait, connection in... I don't think I like your tone, mister.
Well, my tone is very toned. Toned?
I see.
Toned?
Well, thank you very much for joining us, and we are so glad to be back on the air. This is Hollywood LaMarmar signing off with People.
And now for a Channel 80 News Meaning of Life.
So many dimensions coming out of screen.
It's like I can see through the picture.
Into the 21st century.
Into the 23rd century.
Or the 20,000th century.
Oh, I can actually see the blackness.
It's like it surrounds me.
Wasn't it surrounding you already? Oh, here we go. Oh, they're pretty forward about their copyright infringement.
When I was lying there in the VA hospital, with a big hole blown into the middle
okay,
of my
what
life.
The hell? Why is it all fuzzy and stuff?
Shh, it's a movie. I was free.
It's kind of awesome.
It isn't 3D. Can't you? Oh, wait. Where's your glasses?
You always have to wake up.
Didn't you bring any?
What?
Dude, you need glasses.
Glasses?
Ty, you're an idiot.
There's... what?
You're supposed to bring your 3D glasses so you can see everything in 3D.
Wow, whoa. I feel like I'm about to fall.
This movie sure is still in 3D.
What the hell? What are you talking about?
I see.
No, I see a bunch of fuzzy blue crap.
This is awesome.
Here, take these. Shut up, Ty. Just put them on. Stop breaking out!
Cool, huh?
Oh my.
Dude! That is pretty awesome!
Oh, man.
Wow.
I wonder if they have barf bags under the seats.
Yeah, that might be a good idea.
Oh, yeah.
Did I mention I have a problem with heights?
Wow.
No. I feel like I'm participating in their unholy ritual myself.
I really do. I feel like I'm sitting right next to one of those blue dudes.
Brain tumors!
So awesome.
Dude.
Who is it? I don't want to be one of them.
I most certainly do. That,
this
whoa.
Is cool.
I feel like I'm tied down right now with viney things.
Not so interspecies anymore.
Oh, that's awesome.
That was cool.
Whoa. That was a good movie. That really was a
man,
good
man, the last Airbender was way better.
Good movie.
Yeah. Whoa. That was pretty cool. Best $20 I ever spent.
Whoa, everything is way cool. Coming at me. This house is coming right at me. That's... oh wow. What is going on here? Weird trees.
What the? What? It's like
like I'm in a big, wide open
space thing! Whoa! This grass is coming right at me. That's just too freaky. Too freaky.
Whoa! Holy crap, it's like that car's coming right at me or something. It's... Holy, what the?
Never again. Never again. Never again.
It's springtime. Love is in the air as well as excessive pollens. It's time for another episode of Visually Impaired Date. Hello, contestant. Introduce yourself now.
My name is Borda Orealis, and I'm really excited.
Do you like long walks on the beach?
Oh, yeah, except when I get sand in my shoes.
Do you have some sort of astrological sign or signature?
I think it's like that one with the two, but the... An ox? I don't know.
Well, your horoscope says beware of horror in the Ides of March.
That's very important sounding.
Especially since it's April. Bachelor-ish! Introduce yourself now.
My name is Rajneesh, the beast from the Middle East, turning west into east. I'm just here for publicity.
Bachelor-ish number two.
Hi, I'm Tex Rex, right? And, I have a thing for taxidermy.
Okay, bachelor-ish number three.
Ethel.
What do you do?
I drive a school bus.
Excellent. I'll be driving to the next bachelor-ish.
If I tell you my name, they'll know where I am and... No. No. Wait. Johnny.
Kevin O'Henry.
Excellent, Kevin O'Henry.
I am Optimus Prime.
Are you really now?
Well, as far as you know, yes.
Excellent! It's time to begin the wonderful episode of Visually Impaired Date!
Okay, so, if you could take me on a date, where would you take me?
Bachelor's number one, your answer?
We'll probably take you out for some hummus. A long camel ride in the desert.
Yeah. Bachelor-ish number two. Where would you take her on a date?
Probably back down to my basement. Show her my squirrel collection.
Yeah. Bachelor-ish number three.
Damn, kids, I can't believe this. What?
Where would you take the contestant on a date?
How about Chuck E. Cheese so we can take care of some of those frickin' kids? Jeez.
Bachelor-ish number four.
Oh, a wide open area like a plaza or a park where there's lots of people. Lots of people to see if something happens.
Bachelor-ish number five.
That's a terrible idea. I would take her somewhere safe where there are no people or assassins.
Interesting answer. Bachelor-ish number seven.
I would take her to Cybertron.
Why would you take her?
It'd be a really good time.
Well, contestant, which of those answers pleased you the most?
Oh, I like the first one because it sounds really cool to go camel riding. It'd be like horseback, but with, like, camels.
Well, Rajneesh, you seem to be in the lead, but there's time for that to change. Round two! Another question, please, contestant.
Do you like daisies?
Oh, really? That's the question?
That's the question!
Okay. Yeah, I like to rap about daisies sometime.
Bachelor-ish number two?
I got an old dog named Daisy. I like that a lot. Yeah? You like dogs named Daisy, huh?
Bachelor-ish number three.
Daisies? I'll tell you about daisies. Got stupid pollen allergies, and the frickin' bus breaks down, and I'm standing in this field of daisies, sneezing my head off, while the frickin' kids keep screaming in my ears. No, I don't like daisies. Ugh.
Bachelor-ish number four.
Oh, yeah, daisies are nice.
I like him, but I know who doesn't like him. Skinner. He hates daisies. Don't tell him I said that, though.
Bachelorish number you.
I was excited that you guys still have daisies. I mean, of course there's daisies. I love them.
And bachelorish number 7.
I do not so much like organic plant matter, although the aesthetic value is somewhat pleasing. So, I suppose.
Well, contestant, how do you feel about those answers?
I like number 6 because I'm excited about daisies too.
Well, contestant, it's round 3, and you know what that time is?
Car time!
Actually, not quite. If you could see, you'd see on these cue cards back here that it was time to ask personal questions of the bachelorishes.
Oh boy, that sounds like fun!
Who would you like to ask what first?
Oh, whose privacy should I invade? I don't know.
I'm good at that. Oh, wait, no, I'm not.
I guess I should go in order.
That sounds fine.
Okay, alright. Number 1.
Yes?
Do you wear hats?
Too much.
What?
Yes, I do.
Oh, okay. Alright.
Your next question, contestant. Is bachelorish number 1 the person you'd like to have a hat rack for to put their hat on, or do you want to keep going? We'll be back after this emotional breakdown.
Okay, I got it. Number 2, what's your favorite color?
I like the color red.
Red?
Red a lot.
Red like a heart.
Oh yeah, red like a heart.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
Number 3. Did you like kindergarten?
Kindergarten? Hell no! I hate kindergartners. They're the worst. They're the loudest little screaming little twerps on the frickin' bus.
Okay.
No.
My number 3 or number 5? I don't remember anymore. Number 4, what kind of carnival rides and stuff do you like?
Carnival? Carnivals are dangerous. Many things could go wrong and kill me, but no carnivals for me. No, thank you.
Number 6, do you exist? Ah, okay, whatever.
I'm sorry. I took him away.
The audience wants to know what you think of Bachelorishes 5 and 7. Or what you think of what they think. Would you ask what they think?
Number 5, what do you think of what you think? I don't know, is that what I was supposed to say?
I think Bachelorish number 2 would be a great person to go out on a date with. Not me personally, but you and him, maybe.
And number 7, are you secretly a robot?
Yes, he is. He's a robot.
Okay, because you sound kind of like a robot, and I'm just wondering, but, you know.
I don't think it's a secret. That's the point.
Okay, why is there a robot on a dating show? How does that make sense?
It's now time for the elimination round. So far, Rajneesh and this person over here are in the lead.
How am I in the lead? Which person were you talking about?
Exactly. So, contestant, it's time to eliminate 3 of your contestants.
Ah, that's a lot of eliminating at once.
Okay. Oh, don't say eliminate. I don't like eliminations. No, I'm not. No. Mm-mm.
Contestant, who would you like to eliminate?
Number 2's kind of creeping me out, so I think we should kick him.
Bachelorish number 1, how do you feel about that?
Kind of creeping me out too. And I'm a hardcore rapper.
Hardcore Apple, excellent.
Show you,
Bachelorish number 2?
No, no, that's okay.
Once you're done threatening the other bachelor-ish.
Yes, you sure, cannot buddy? Touch me. That would be very nice.
Okay. All right, bachelor-ish number three, how do you feel about this choice?
Hey, you know, I'm thinking of retiring soon. You might actually have a job with the school district if the tax and everything just doesn't work out after the show and everything, so. Oh,
excellent yeah. business I'll, arrangements. I'll bachelor-ish number four.
I'm thankful it wasn't me, and yes, he will be missed, but,
Bachelor-ish number five seems to be missing. It's odd.
He's sleeping with the fishes. They know. I shouldn't have told him about Smokey. Oh, Skinner.
Bachelor-ish number seven.
Got him.
Well, your voice modulator appears to be defective. So, contestant, any last words?
Never mind. Actually, I changed my mind. I think I'm going to eliminate number four. Because they just sound too grumpy.
Number four, huh?
Wait!
Yeah.
I get to... Don't eliminate me!
Not gone, right?
What the heck just happened here?
Well, you're back, contestant number five. I might as well ask you how you feel about contestant four going away.
No, come on, man. We're buddies. Don't do it.
I feel great.
Excellent. Goodbye, contestant number four. You'll be escorted out back into an unmarked van at this time. That's right, a van by the river.
I'm driving.
No, you need to stay here.
It's that time again, contestant. Time for the final question. And then two people will be gone, leaving only your three finalists.
Okay. I've got it then. Are you a man?
Bachelor-ish number one.
Yes, I am.
Bachelor-ish number two.
I'm more man than you can handle.
Bachelor-ish three.
Maybe you have to have that way, miss.
No, Danny, little Miller, you little twerp. How about
Bachelor-ish number five.
Yes, I am.
Bachelor-ish number seven.
I can be whatever you want me to be, baby.
Well, contestant.
Okay, I think I'm going to eliminate number three because it doesn't sound like a man.
I'm not, thank you. I'll finally get back to working on the bus.
And who else?
Number seven, because he's being creepy. Well,
goodbye, number seven. Well, three finalists. You each get to have the honor of unwrapping your visually impaired date. Take off her blindfold now.
Who's this thing? What the
hell? Wow, you look just like the photo.
Oh my gosh, thank you. Was it a good photo?
Sure.
What photo?
Yeah.
Okay. It's now time for your dates.
Yay!
Hi, this is one of my favorite things to do. I like to look at the dogs before, you know, see them again and gotta take out their insides.
Oh, so like that one thing that starts with T? It's like...
Yeah, I'm a taxidermist.
Oh, okay.
I stuff animals.
I love stuffed animals. Oh my gosh, I have like 5 million of them.
Oh, I've got lots of stuffed animals back in my place.
Oh, I want to see.
Oh, lots of squirrels.
I love squirrels.
Got my dog Daisy. Yeah. Anyway, here we go.
So, we're here. This is one of the shows I'm putting on. He's on my label.
Ah, see. Do you make lots of money? Yes. Cool. What do you buy with the money?
Let's see. Camel groomers.
Oh, okay. So when do we get to the camel rides?
Whoa. I wasn't actually serious about that.
Oh, okay. All right.
Whoa. Maybe, but...
Don't we need like a desert anyway? I mean, I don't think there's a desert around here.
No, he's in the Kamala city right now.
Oh, okay.
So,
all right.
Yeah.
So, this is like kind of boring.
What do you mean, contestant? Isn't bachelorish fun?
Are you gonna stand over by the tree all day?
No, no, I was just looking at it. There's not a lot of trees that, like that, where I'm from.
Where are you from? Like the desert? Are there camels?
Camels. Robo camels?
Oh, that sounds pretty cool.
But you hate camels, right? Oh. I mean, because you're... So, I'm interested, like... Oh, a memorial, huh? Mm-hmm. I remember this bench. It's not in as good a shape, though. How did your date with Tex go?
Tex, which one is he? I forgot, like, everyone's names. I don't even know yours.
I think he was bachelor's number two.
Oh, you mean the guy with the stuffed animals. It was pretty cool. Why are you so interested?
Good, it's just, I think it'd be great if you found a connection on the show. That was not me, Rajnish.
I'm not sure what you're trying to say, but okay.
Are you attempting to forfeit your position on Visually Impaired Date?
Now, just hold up. I just think it's important for you to stay safe and fertile. And paired with particular people.
Okay.
Very... let's take a look.
Okay.
What do you know about tachyons?
Absolutely nothing. I think I saw a guy on the internet with that name once.
That's great.
He was a troll.
A troll? Yeah. So, do you like stuffed animals?
I like stuffed animals, yeah. Do you?
I think that would be great for you. I personally would like it if you paired up with certain people.
Okay.
It's very important to me.
I think I get it now.
Do you?
Uh-huh. You want me to date the stuffed animal guy?
Not in so many words. You didn't hear it from me.
Okay, alright.
Well, it's wonderfully articulate that this gentleman has brought forth the final question. Which of these bachelorishes do you choose?
You lied to me about camels, so I'm gonna go with him. Because he probably has stuffed camels.
What? You stuffed a camel, you sick bastard!
I'm sorry.
What the?
Well, congratulations! I hope you two are very happy. Yay! Thank you for this wonderful episode of Visually Impaired Dave.
Don't feel so bad. You'll have a very lucrative career.
Oh!
And now I gotta jump.
Okay, what are you going?
I need a time jump. Emergency. Temporal.
What in the hell just happened? Why did I show up to this thing? I'm out of here.
Woo! I have done what no one has done before. I have stolen the mask from Bonanza the Furious.
Bonanza, baby. The mask of epicness has been taken. We must find it. Let's find it, Bonanza baby. We'll split up. I know. You're distraught. It's okay.
Now he has no point to accept my challenge.
You bastard! You stole my mask!
Kick your butt!
Now that I have the mask of power, you will do my bidding. You will find the idol of monkey freakishness. Thank you, Slinky, but there's still much work to be done.
Welcome to Channel 80 News. I'm your host, Joseph Chapman, and now our breaking stories. In international entertainment news, we have a story about Justin Bieber, who recently had his entire entourage arrested under the suspicion of kidnapping and pedophilia until the cops realized he often travels with a huge group of black men. In international intermotives, I'm going to cut there.
Hi, I'm Lady Dramamine. Oh wait, shit, my hair's not down. Hang on. Hi, I'm Lady Dramamine. Do you have a house? Is it messy? Then let me... Shit.
Spring is in the air, and that means it's time for another exciting episode of Visually Impaired Date. We'd like to introduce you to our contestant today. What is your name, miss?
Fictional something. I don't have...
It's that time again, contestant. One more round of questions, and then two people will be gone.
Okay. Oh, I've got one. Okay. Wait. I'm sorry.
Jesus. Oh, oh,
yep, I can just feel it. You're gone. Feel like the fucking Titanic. Here I go.
You are out.
I want to see it.
Here it goes.
Are you okay?
Down with the ship. Oh, there it goes. Sinking right into the ground.
Jeremy, there's no recovery at this point.
Well, maybe you shouldn't have taken my chair.
I filmed it for you, Margaret.
Yay!
No, I'm just going to sit right in the
Yeah, so I was going to say, sit down on the front of the chair first. Oh, then geez. Maybe it won't sink into your back like that.
Right now.
Sorry! I'm sorry, we didn't find the mask today, Bonanza Baby.
You mean the idol?
Now he has...
We're going to start over.
Okay, but he has no choice.
No, no.
What the? Mom! Just like I planned, he will get caught up.